Welcome to the Art Project. I took a trip to Almost Circle Gallery this week, and I'm going to let Julia Reyes give you a tour of it. If you want to find out more, you can click on the links down below. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the thumbs up. And if you got any questions, please leave them in the comments down below. Thanks.
Hi, my name is Julia Reyes, and I am the owner and operator here at Almost Circle Gallery, and I'm also a visual artist. I'm going to take you guys a little bit around the gallery. What we do here is we do a lot of rotating art exhibits featuring local and regional artists. I also have my studio in here. We do special events varying from things that kind of cross disciplines of different artists, art fests. This exhibit features Leif Anderson. She's a native of Ocean Springs, Mississippi. She is a dancer, writer, visual artist. She's also the daughter of Walter Anderson, who's a well-known watercolor artist from Ocean Springs. So. Here we have Robert Baldwin. He's from Madison, Florida, and he works in a variety of mediums. And here we have a selection of drawings throughout his life and all of the sculptural work in here. Faces are also by him. A lot of his work is sort of reflective of family dynamic and different family situations, scenarios. Yeah, so those are from an installation, or part of an installation I did, actually with Summer Baldwin, who is the, it was for a performance called A Loneliness, and they were hanging in the on the stage, and they sort of casted these shadows as the dancers performed on stage, and that is something I am experimenting with. I've been really into embroidering and the act of stitching, because when I approach painting, I'm usually super aggressive and kind of work in a lot of layers, and there's something meditative about the act of stitching. I built it for a show of shadow puppets, knowing that I was gonna later stitch into it. I also teach classes out of here. All of the spaces are sort of open to change. It just changes all the time, constantly.
Is there a correlation between these and what looked kind of like your houses and the houses that you did?
Definitely. So a lot of this imagery, this shape actually, I liked it because it reminded me of the rooftops of a house, but then it also looks like the Marlboro symbol, which reminds me of my mom.
Right.
So I've been using that shape for a really long time in different ways, and then the house shape I've used a lot, deconstructing that house shape. So you'll see in some of the paintings, like that one up top where it's like a full unfolded, almost origami like.
Here's another.
Yeah, and that one. I like kind of taking ordinary objects and then deconstructing them and abstracting them. So sometimes I'll start really representational, but then the more I use it, I'll kind of abstract it more in some paintings than others. But my dad, he's an engineer, so I was always around, someone taking things apart. And right. So I enjoy, kind of seeing how things work, but I don't necessarily know how to put them back together. I always joke that my life is like a constant state of creating chaos just so I can resolve that chaos. I feel like it's...
I think a lot of people are
everybody's like that. Why does it have to be this way?
Right.
It's a house shape, but it can literally only fit one human inside of it, or one person. So it's almost like this forced isolation. And if you're stitching, that's something that's very meditative. So it's almost like this little sacred space where you're able to just stitch and kind of wander.
Are you inviting people to do their own stitching on this construction?
Yep. And I don't really give any instruction. It's amazing because how people just know that that's what they're supposed to do. And even if they don't normally stitch on a daily basis, it's something that's kind of just comes natural.
Right.
For all ages, men, women.
They can figure it out.
Yeah. And then some people, sort of are very meticulous about their stitches, and then some people are kind of erratic. I've had, grown men sit here for like over an hour just stitching. So eventually I'm sure it'll probably be completely covered. And occasionally if I'm having a take a moment.
Take a break.
Yeah. That's Brent Hausinga. I don't know if I said his name right. But he works in different stencil layers, layered stencils, and he's based out of New Orleans. I had a show with his work and Sam Stolte a couple months ago. He was working from images that he found. He found an old album. And so all of these are based on strangers, basically.
And then up there you've got Paulette.
Yeah, Paulette's.
Me and Paulette have been friends for a while.
So I got to, when I saw she was going to be here, I made sure I got to come see the show.
Oh, yeah. That is Sarah Karkish. And her and her husband actually just started a workshop in Ocean Springs, but they do kind of fine art furniture and custom type of work. They do a lot of cool stuff. So they have like a live workspace in Ocean Springs. Pretty awesome. They bought a metal building and built it out.
And these are yours?
Yeah, these are a couple more little houses.
What about these?
Those are Stacy Johnson, and now she works at Gulf Coast Episcopal. She's a teacher there.
Okay.
Yeah, she has really nice work. And these little cups are hers also. I don't have any of her larger sculptures, but she does a lot of figurative stuff. Up with future happenings at Almost Circle Gallery, you can follow our Facebook page, or you can check out our website at almostcircle.com. And so we're always doing different things, changing it up every month, so come on by.
All right.